Michael Owenzie, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show, first of all, we've got Thumbtipedia by Verne. Is it Verne or Vernet? Translator.
I have always called it Verne, yeah. With a silent T. However, we watched the DVD, and the man that works for...
Well, he's a translator, has it? I think he does work for them, though.
Yeah, I guess he was paid by them through the DVD.
Yeah.
Technically working for them.
Right, okay.
But he said Vernet.
Vernet, so maybe it's Vernet, I'm not sure.
Or maybe the translation company at...
Valet or Vanet, I don't know. First of all, it's a DVD about techniques of the thumb tip. You do get a rather nice sort of basic thumb tip, the standard Vernet thumb tip.
They are the people for thumb tips, you know. I remember as a kid, I wanted the Vernet thumb tip.
Yeah, they're good stuff. And you get lots of ideas on here. And there's professional routines explained, because that's the idea of the DVD. It's kind of like an encyclopedia of stuff that you can do with a thumb tip. Mm. Not just for close-up, but for parlour. And some gags just for magicians as well. More on that later. And some things that we'd seen before, but we'd kind of forgotten about.
But I think what this is... When I was 14, right, and I thought I knew everything about magic. I knew everything, right? And and I thumb tip would poo-pooed by myself.
Yeah.
You know, because everyone knows how to make this little red handkerchief.
That's all it did, right?
And that's what a thumb tip did. From whatever DVD or video or book that I then bought, which is kind of what they're saying, this type of thing, my eyes were suddenly open.
For me, that moment...
What the heck? And that's what this is.
For me, that moment was seeing David Williamson do this theatrical vanish of the salt and then returning to the cup, which is explained on this DVD. Ideas from David Williamson, Roger Klaus, just the very basic, but fantastic. I use it in just about every show that they got video projection. Bill Switch.
$100 Bill Switch.
So these are things that professionals use all the time. They're on this DVD, they're explained, not just silk vanishers, but some things that we were actually looking at and thinking, that is really clever.
The invisible thumb tip.
Me and Sean haven't seen before. This technique where you can use a thumb tip in a very, very clever way that you end completely clean. They're never aware of a thumb tip, and yet it can vanish.
And your thumbs are examined at the end.
Yeah, it can vanish bigger things, balls, anything you want, really, because it's used more like a pull than it is a thumb tip. The invisible thumb tip that is explained on this.
In fact, it even allows you to take your thumbs off at the end and have them examined.
Yeah, if you want to do that. There's gags for magicians. Yeah. There's all sorts of things on here. It's actually a very good DVD. If you're an established magician, you're going to look through it and there's going to be bits that you're going to go, actually, that's quite clever, like the cut and restored silk.
It's also a memory jogger, because I got this and I was like, the David Williamson trick. Yeah. I've not done that for a long time.
The cut and restored silk, very, very clever indeed, rolls up a piece of paper, puts sort of a 24-inch silk in one end, takes the silk out the other end, cuts it with the scissors, it's definitely separate, and then he restores it at the end. Quite simple. Obviously, you know the secret because you get the gimmick with the DVD, but at the same time, very, very clever indeed. Look, I thought I wasn't going to like this, but there are at least a couple of things that have really got me thinking, especially this invisible thumb tip thing.
Yeah,
so I'm going to give it over 90%. I'm going to give it 92%. How much are you going
to
give it?
Well, you know that I've already gone, I need to use the thumb tip thing.
Invisible thumb tip.
With my dice
technique,
trick.
Yeah.
So I have to get over 90%. So it's 91% from me.
Yeah, but there is an issue, actually. In the magician's section, there is a thing on there, and the crediting is pretty good up to this point. He did a thumb tip matrix on the DVD, and I thought that this was actually the intellectual copyright of Etienne Pradier from the UK, and it turns out that that is the case.
Well, he's done it at FISM.
He's done it at FISM.
He's done it at the International Magic Competition.
And it was performed, unfortunately, without credit. Now, obviously, Etienne is a... very sophisticated performer. He's performed, like myself, actually, for the Royal Household on a number of occasions at very high-end gigs. And we got in touch with Etienne's office and got him to actually issue this statement.
Manche tout, manche tout. In 2003, I did a routine with matrix, with thumb tips, right? Now, apparently, some mother put it on a DVD and didn't mention me. Je ne crois pas, man. What the is going on with you, boy? Now, listen to me. I'm going to ask my ex-girlfriend to come and see you, and she's going to show you what she used to do with thumb tips. Watch out, mange tout. What, mate? Why?
So, thank you very much, Etienne, and that is the review of Thumbtippedia.
I've actually got one of Etienne's old thumb tips at home.
Have you?
Oof. It's not often that something new comes to magic, but yes. Ladies and gentlemen, today we present to you the famous...
Appearing
biscuits.
Appearing dog chew.
Appearing biscuits.
And there we go. Blammo, look at that. Come on, yeah, now we've got his attention. Come up here.
The reason we couldn't actually have Blammo on the couch then is because he is actually made out of flash wool entirely. It would have been bad.
We just rigged this up very quickly.
There'd have been biscuits everywhere.
We're going to put some close-ups on the screen and show you what this is. This is a Braco finger flasher. So once again, we will put some clips up, not only from the trailer, but from the gimmick really close up, so you can see this, that it works quite well. We just got it out of the box and started messing around with this. I did have one of these years ago for a cut and restored rope.
They're brilliant.
And you just had that moment where you went, bang, we just want to blammo out of the way.
I used to use them, and then I didn't have a trick. But those Christmas parties, you know, where there's like 100 tables and it's mental and there's music and stilt walkers and too much noise. I just used to walk up to tables and go,
bang, there you go.
Right, I'm the magician. I'm in.
It works with a flint, and you can change the flint quite easily. That comes out. It's not metal, it's plastic. But we've used it a few times with the flash wool, putting the flash wool in. Although it gets a bit dull on the inside, it certainly protects your fingers very, very nicely because the way that it's hidden inside your hand.
It's very hard plastic, though, isn't it?
Yeah, hard plastic, and it's very nicely contoured. It's very ergonomic.
It sits and on your third finger there, and it is just right.
Very easy to set off. You're going to get that big flash. You're going to get that reaction. You could do it behind a deck of cards. This is an ordinary deck of cards. Huge flash, and then produce it. It actually works very well. The only thing that I was a bit disappointed with, and it's pretty naff, is the elastic you get with it. The elastic for the pull, terrible. You're going to need to get your own elastic, probably a more durable safety pin as well. But the actual gimmick itself, I'm actually glad I've got one of these. It's a nice little gimmick. I'm going to give this exactly 90%.
Yeah, I'm already using one, so I've got to give it 90%.
And we've had the appearing biscuit trick. We'll now present to you the vanishing biscuit trick. Thank you very much.
Finish the trick, Blammo.
Has he not finished it?
No, it's only done half.
Still working on it.
Half a job.
Get back to us.
So, next up, we've got The Top It by David Penn.
Yeah, 99%.
Right, next up, we've got the transformation. So we've got the topic.
A few people have been asking questions.
Yeah, I mean, I suppose all the knowledgeable magicians will maybe have used the topic before. All the newish to magic magicians may have heard of the topic but never played with the topic. So I guess there's three questions. Question one, what is the topic?
Is a hidden device inside your jacket. It was popularised by shoplifters. They called it a whiz pocket. Magicians call it a top it. It means that you can vanish things very quickly, small objects, and as well as vanish things, you can clean up and get rid of gimmicks that you've got hidden in your hands, things that you shouldn't have at the end of routines.
And next question. Top it has been around a very, 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 very long time. Why is this topic a new topic? What's different
about it? Topic 180. It's called 180 because it goes from the front all the way round to the back. The back being the middle of the back, right round to the front. You can vanish things, and when you vanish something into it, small objects, be it cards, an eight ball, a coin or whatever, it is then transited round to a holding area, and that holding area is at the back of the jacket.
Mm-hmm.
So that means without going in your pocket or anything like that, because that's been done before, which renders that pocket actually pretty useless, you can then steal from whatever is vanished into the top it or covertly placed in there. You can steal that object again from the back, as demonstrated quite freely actually on the trailer. It's very informative, as well as stealing things from that area, you can ditch into that area.
Okay.
So it's kind of like a toppet at the front and a ditching area, kind of like a smaller version of a toppet at the back. So brilliant. You can do so much with it.
Yeah. Okay, and it says here RH, because this one's being sent out to Richard Hargreaves. but yeah, I know you can also get them in right and left-handed versions.
Right, so and left-handed.
How do I know which one I need to buy?
Quite simple. If you do a coin vanish, any coin vanish at all, or a French drop, it is the hand that you're holding the coin with to start with. Before you do the vanish, that would mean that you are right-handed if you're holding it with your right hand, and it's going to end up palmed in your right hand at the end of a French drop. That is how handed you are.
So I'm right. I write with my right hand. I throw with my right hand. But yeah, my French drop would naturally end up over here.
Well, if you end up...
Which means I need to buy a left-handed toppet.
Yes. Right. Because when you end up with the object in this hand...
Yeah, that's what you're doing. Yeah.
That's the easiest way to judge it. You would dispose of it using that hand. So if you're right-handed, for me, the toppet goes on the left-hand side of my body, but it's a right-handed toppet because it gets vanished like this, be it the base of the wine glass, the eight ball. It gets vanished using your right hand. That is what handed you are, not what side of the body the toppet is placed.
So I'm right-handed, but I need a left-handed toppet so I can vanish it onto the right side of my body.
There you go. However you do your magic, it doesn't necessarily mean whether you're right-handed or left-handed.
But it makes sense. So it does make complete sense, because you don't know how the toppet works. You're doing this with it. And so I'm French drop, false transfer, it stays over here. That obviously makes sense. It then needs to go over there.
Exactly.
Perfect sense. So, it's great. You've had some brilliant quotes from this, haven't you?
Yeah, Wayne Dobson's gave me an amazing quote. Doc Eason, Luke Dancy. I was showing loads of guys at this at Magic Live. It was getting great reviews. We're going to release some more information and as we release more of those quotes in the future, because comments are coming in all the time, getting lots of very nice Facebook messages from people that have received it in the last few days as well, because it only got released on Saturday. If you haven't seen the trailer yet, go on to worldmagicshop.com, into the search area, type toppet 180, and you'll find the right and left-handed version there. It's exactly the same, apart from one is for this side of the body, one's for the other side of the body, but order the one as described for whichever handed you are, whichever hand it ends up in after you've done a French drop.
And if you, and as from an investment point of view, if you were thinking about getting one of these, if you did want to use it as a whiz pocket, it's not going to take you that long to recuperate your money back.
It's a good point. And when I was young, I did have the full set of Star Wars figures. Bear that in mind. They're quite expensive. Transformation Silk
by Dominic Duvivier.
I'm glad you said that name. I wasn't 100% sure. I reckon this audience is stooged. What do you reckon?
A little bit.
I think, what was it you said? He filmed it at his local magic club.
Looks like he filmed it at his local magic club.
You can't use the same gimmick again and again and again, and everybody going wild each time. I think they start to figure it out. First of all, this is a utility device. It's a silk handkerchief about sort of 24 inches square. Is that fair to say?
Maybe a little bit smaller, about 20.
Be careful. We don't want to expose this gimmick. I'm sure you won't be able to figure this out without it.
I'm not going to expose the gimmick.
That is the size of the handkerchief. There we go. So it's about 18 inches.
And I'm going to do the move.
There we go. Whoa!
I did the move. So that's what it looks like. Right, that's not the magic trick. But so the secret bit obviously works, because I just did it.
This is a utility device. It's a handkerchief that you can show on both sides. Nothing there, Governor. And then you shake it. And then in the action of shaking it, you can produce an object. I think Sean is covertly...
We've not rehearsed. We're just going to do it.
You're going to do it without any rehearsal.
I didn't even
open it half an hour ago. You can do it already.
I'm going to make somebody...
Are you ready? Let me clear the performing area. Are you ready for this? You've built this up now into an amazing moment. All this preparation going on right now down there. You're very nearly in view. Are you ready? Are you ready yet? Come on.
It's quite complicated stuff.
I have to have an edit here. This is really boring. Right, you ready
to
do it?
Here we go.
You need to show both sides of it.
And I'm going to make a business card randomly appear on the table.
Oh my God. Robin Kershaw. There we go.
Don't plug him.
So, there you go. And although that looked pretty weak, that is actually the level of some of the effects that's actually described on the DVD, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
The download, sorry. Things like a card being returned to a deck, and then that one card coming out. I think...
Right, here's the thing. Here is the thing.
I've got
this,
so much respect for this guy. Don't
Dominic Duvivier, I love him. Great guy, right? Great DVD, actually, right?
Okay, in what way? You did say
not
about this,
right? What it is, if you... a lot of the things that he's... specifically Dominic Duvivier and his... I think it's his daughter.
Yeah, it is.
Are teaching you and involve card forces.
Yeah.
Right? And he's given some really good work on the kind of a Hindu shuffle, because we had this conversation before that are we convinced that the Hindu shuffle really convinces people?
So.
The way that Dominic Duvivier teaches you, he's got a nice subtlety on
Fair
there.
To say.
And it's very good. It's very deceptive. So for me, I've watched that and I've gone, okay. I've learned something from Dominic about the Hindu shuffle.
Okay, that's a bonus, but we've actually bought a transformation silk, a utility device that performs all these incredible effects. Let's talk about what you get, bang for buck. You get your gimmick. Does it deliver on routine? Do you get amazing tricks? You don't, do you?
You get tricks.
What you get, they're not strong.
Boxer shorts, the appearing boxer shorts.
There's a guy on there. What is this guy on? I don't know what they're smoking over there in France. But seriously, there's a guy on there, and he's like, you've heard of Harry Potter, the Cloak of Invisibility. And this is obviously translated. And he shows the black cloth, and then he holds it in front of his pants, his body, and then, amazingly, a pair of boxer shorts appears. We'll put some clips on the screen if we can download their instructions to put over the top. But you see the boxer shorts, like, just appear there, and then he starts going into all this work about extra boxer shorts, and you're just thinking, really? No? I think the thing is with this, the handkerchief, it's the sort of thing, if you were a production company making a TV show, or you made, like, a lot of... social media videos, you would kind of get one of these, because I think there'll be a time when you'll need to do something and this might actually save you, because you can produce just about anything.
Yeah, like you said, cockroach, a freaky out magic specialist, cockroaches on a dinner plate.
Yeah, yeah, that's what you would use it for. You can produce just about anything from this handkerchief. The effects on the DVD, don't take that into consideration. I don't think it shows it to its full potential.
Yeah,
You've got a gimmick here that you might actually use at one stage. I don't have a use for it right now, I'm not going to be giving it a great mark.
No, what I was hoping for this, because I knew what it was before I watched the video. And I was actually hoping for the handling of this to be a bit more clever and deceptive to what it is. Because I don't necessarily think that getting something black and then going like that and having something, I mean, they do the handling.
It may as well be in your sleeve if you're going to go like this. This is what I don't get.
Well, look, especially with a card production, right? And I haven't got a playing card.
Well, we'll put it on the screen. The clip will be on the screen.
No, so I've got a business card. Because if the people can't do that thing that's taught the basic things, where it looks like you're showing your hands empty when you're really palming a card, you know, and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
You don't need something that big to hide something that big, necessarily.
To produce a card.
But if you don't want to use any
sleight of hand at all, I guess that's what they're pitching for. Look, I'm not going to use it. I don't particularly like it. It's quite good quality, you know.
Yeah.
It's not just material. It's got weights involved and that kind of thing. It is quite a clever gimmick. But
it's worth getting for the card forces as well. I mean, I like the card force bit.
It's just an excuse, because you like Dominic. That's it. You're trying to make it better than it really is. And it's not that, really. It's all right. It's 46% at best. At best. How much are you going to give it?
I am going to...
Don't give it marks for the card forces. That's not what they've spent their money on when they bought it. They bought transformation silk.
Card forces, I'm going to vote at 79%. But the transformation silk... 39%.
39%. It's about that. Unless you've got a use for it, but you might find a use for it one day.
But I really like Dominic, though, so there we cross. And next up...
Finally!
I looked at the product, I looked at the gimmick, I checked it out, and I thought we had a Sans Mines special on our hands.
Burn Notice by Tekel.
But it's by Tekel, not Sans Mines.
Yeah, I know. And this is a Murphy's Black Label. Wow! It must be good, right?
Right.
Do you want to synopsisize the effect?
What you do, you've got this very nice black box, packaged very nicely.
Yeah.
And the effect is it's a card to impossible location. Not just any part of impossible location. Yeah, right. But a strike anywhere matches, safety matches, matchbox impossible location.
This matchbox is left out, it's on the table, it's in full view all the time, a card vanishes. Ooh, it's gone.
You could open up
the matchbox.
You couldn't vanish it, you couldn't do like a combo.
That's way
with
too
this,
good for
it?
This.
Yeah.
Right, so you push it in there. It looks awkward, so it's kind of like, you know, this card to impossible location. First of all, there's been versions out before with matchboxes. We'll put clips on the screen. Don't risk doing it. It's not fair.
I'm not going to do it.
You haven't even rehearsed it.
I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to show.
It's just going to go wrong.
I'm not doing it.
Yeah, that's
just
how it
showing
looks.
You. That's how it looks. It's a bit awkward to get out. And all that. I'm not going to do it.
The thing is, we'll put a clip on there, because we have got the clip of this, when he reaches over to take the card out of the matchbox. It just doesn't seem fair. It doesn't seem like it really comes out. It doesn't look neat to me. You know, with something like Mystery Solved or Mark Southworth's effects, you know, the box and that kind of thing.
Okay, right, let me stop.
When you tip it out, you're convinced that it's coming out of there. It seems fair.
But, right, Mystery Solved, there's two different things for me, right? And I'll tell you why, right? This I would be comparing with Tommy Wonder's card in cigar box. Because, right, no, not as good, because you can't see the card. Mystery Solved is something, here's an impossible object, so it's been there on view the whole time.
Well, it's meant for predictions.
Your prediction,
Solved,
prediction, yeah, but it's different. It's been there, it's like, it's a dream card effect. The dream card effect is the card's been on display the whole time.
Yeah.
Right, that's a dream card plot. This is card two, impossible location, which means it's the apparent appearance of the card in there, right? Which people are going to, you know, Tommy Wonders is my favourite way of doing that.
Yeah.
Which is, it's kind of that type of thing, but just nowhere near.
You can't examine the matchbox afterwards.
No.
Not that you want to, really. I'm just giving you the lowdown on this.
It
looks awkward. From the moment that you're pushing it out the drawer, everything looks awkward and doesn't look free, and it's really in there, and it doesn't look great. You get an 11-minute download with it, with some extra tips, things like what I shared on the Mystery Solved DVD, how to prepare cards, so it's easy to Mercury card fold cards. And there's an idea on there with an envelope where you already fold the card into quarters.
It's just ridiculous.
This is bad magic.
Right, I'm
going to
go again.
It?
When there's things on the market, like people's life's work, like Tommy Wonder's card in the cigar box and card in the cigar, right, you just don't go anywhere. How can you even consider buying something like that?
Well, that thing he did with the envelope, where he puts it in the envelope and then he tears up the envelope. Any punter knows where that
exactly
card
is. They know exactly where the card is.
They know where that card is at that stage. Sorry to break that to you. But this, it's a nice little bit of fun. It's a nice little bit of fun, but you're never going to use it. It's to be honest, when you spent the money on it, that's not even fun. It's pretty terrible. I didn't like this at all. I think there's better versions on the market. I think Mark Southworth even had a version with a matchbox at one stage.
Yeah.
It was even better than this, cleaner than this. It's been done before, it's been done better. The creator doesn't do it particularly well. Sorry to be so hard on him. I look forward to seeing new inventions from this guy, but we've got to be honest on the Wizard product review. I wouldn't get burnt notice if I took out. I don't think it's a stronger paint.
Where are you going to
get it? 15%.
Wow.
11%. That's it this week for the Wizard product review. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll be back in about 2 weeks' time. Until next time, I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next time on the Wizard product review.
Yeah.
Good boy. Do you want a wee wee?
Yeah, I do need a wee actually.
I'm David Penn and this is Top It 180. It's a topic like no other.
as well as being able to vanish and transform objects like any standard toppet, first of all, it fits in your jacket within minutes. It's transferable between jackets within minutes. And it also means that you can steal and ditch into the very same device. And that's because after an object has been transformed or vanished into the toppet, it is transited due to the unique design to a holding area. That holding area is at the back of my jacket, so when I go to the next table, under very little misdirection, I can reach over and I can steal that object again. This has never been possible before with any other toppet. You can vanish, steal, and under very little misdirection, you can ditch into the very same device.